Hi everyone! So this is going to be part two for Ateez Color Theory. I wasn't really planning on making this video, but I got a lot of comments, people wanting to know my thoughts on fever, so here we are. Now this is going to be a little bit different from my normal videos. It's not going to be like a nice, fancy, polished video essay. I basically have a whole set of PowerPoints, and I'm just going to go through the slides and annotate on top of them. I didn't really want to cut out a whole bunch of stuff to get this down to being just like a 10 to 20 minute video, and I just don't have the time or energy to devote to editing a really, really long video. So you're getting like the sad discount version of Tiny Bug video today. The live action version, if you will. First, we have to go through a lot of disclaimers. Sorry. The first one is noise. I live in like a studio apartment above businesses and shops and stuff in my city's downtown. So you will hear cars and people on the street below me and sirens and the train. I'm really sorry. I can't do anything about it. I normally record all my voiceovers at like 3 in the morning, and even then I have to do a lot of sound editing to take out all the noise pollution and cars and stuff. But I'm not going to do that today, so the audio quality of this video is just going to be a little bit bad, and we're going to deal with it. So this is more of an apology. YouTube gives me like statistics about all my videos, and I know that my first Ateez Color Theory video is the video of mine with the most diverse audience. Like people all around the world have watched that video, and probably a fair amount of people who don't speak English fluently or speak English as their second language. And I realized that this format of a big, long, rambly, unscripted video is not the most accessible video for people who don't speak English. So I'm really sorry. If you have questions or things you want me to explain better, I will try my best to answer comments. I will never make fun of you for not having perfect English. That's a shitty thing to do to someone. Or, you know, you can probably just also ask in your language, because I guarantee you somebody else is watching this video who speaks your language and might be able to help you better than me. Because I only speak one language, because I'm pathetic. So I haven't 100% decided if I'm going to do this. I sort of want my YouTube channel to be for my more professional, well-edited videos, and I don't really want this to be up permanently. I was originally going to do this as a live stream, but when I asked on my community tab, there were only like 10 people who said they would watch a live stream. If I take the video down, it won't be permanently deleted. I'm just going to change it to being an unlisted video. So an unlisted video on YouTube means that it won't show up in search results, it won't show up in like recommendations. If you go to my channel page and you click on videos, it's not going to be there. For an unlisted video, you have to have the link to get to the video. Like you have to go directly to the video. So the link will be posted, as always, in my Twitter, and I'll probably put a pinned comment under my first Ateez Color Theory video with the link. So you'll still be able to watch it and share it and stuff, but this video, it's more like a special treat for everyone who asked for it, and it's a present to you guys, so it might be a little bit exclusive. I think there's been some misconceptions about who I am, which is that I am not a theorist. I am an art nerd. I made a video where I was like, oh my gosh, pretty colors. Ateez does a thing. And then all of these people were like, you know things. No, no, I want to be clear. I don't know anything. I don't know jack shit. I am not, and I do not want to be, any kind of authority on the Ateez universe storyline. I do think the color theory stuff is very much a part of their whole universe storyline, and I am going to talk about it a bit, but I am not a theorist. I do not make theory videos. If you thought this video was going to be me entirely explaining their universe storyline, I'm going to ask you to lower your expectations. That way, I can exceed them. Thank you. Collaboration is cool. I really want other people who are not me to talk about Ateez Color Theory and share your own opinions and your own perspective on things. You have my permission. You didn't need it, but you have it. I'm probably not going to make another one of these. Maybe. I mean, I didn't think I was going to make this video, so we'll see. But this is not like a pyramid with me at the top dictating information down to my subjects below. No. This is a relay race, and I've run my section, and I'm done. And now it's your turn. And if you write something, your own theory or whatever, you know, I feel free to tell me. I would love to see it. If you put hashtag Ateez Color Theory on it, especially on Twitter, then maybe people who are not me, who are also interested in this, can also read it too. That would be cool. I pretty closely follow the Ateez Color Theory search term on Twitter, so I basically see everything that anyone posts about Ateez Color Theory, and I actually think I've freaked a couple people out because they'll be like talking about my video and I'll just like hop in the comments and be like, hey. But it's fine. I've met a lot of cool people on Twitter that way. But yeah, you are all lovely and insightful people, and I'm sure you can all take this idea way further than I ever could. I want to see other people talk about this. That being said, plagiarism is not cool, and I have unfortunately had a lot of issues with plagiarism and my first Ateez Color Theory video. I had one person type out, like, word for word, the entire script, like, the whole video, and post it to Twitter. And when I confronted them about it, they blocked me, so that was fun. There have been several other people who have made big, long threads called Ateez Color Theory, in which, like, 70% of the Twitter thread is lifted directly from my video. They'll talk about a bunch of the same things, use the exact same examples, like paraphrase big sections of my video, and even like completely take direct quotes from me and then post it to Twitter and act like it's something they came up with. And like, I can tell when someone is on Twitter and they're like, look at this music video, oh my gosh, it's red and blue. Like, I can tell when people are just excited or noticing the exact same thing that I noticed and want to talk about it. And I can tell when someone watched my video and then made a whole big long thread copying it. I don't think people understand how much time and effort I put into my videos. I mean, that video took me 4 months to make. So someone taking 10 minutes to watch my video and then spending 10 minutes typing it up on Twitter and pretending like it's their own work is really, I mean, it's really disrespectful. So if you're going to do this, and especially if you're going to take direct quotes from me, you have to provide sources or credit. Say whatever, the Tiny Bugs video about color theory, or link the video or tag me, or literally anything. I really feel like I'm asking for the bare minimum level of respect here. And like, you don't have to credit me every single time you talk about Ateez Color Theory. No. If you're talking about your own thoughts and your own ideas, that's fine. but I'm not okay with people straight up taking my whole video and acting like it's theirs. And a part of the reason I've been hesitant on calling these people out is because I know the accounts of people who are doing this, and it's like teenagers on Twitter. And I'm not looking to just start drama with just like random teenagers on Twitter. Being a teenager is terrible, and I don't want to make their lives worse. And so this is not an excuse for you to be an asshole to someone on my behalf. If you see someone doing this in the future, either one, do nothing, just send it to me and I will take care of it, or two, leave a thoughtful, appropriate comment, say, hey, maybe you don't know, Tinybug has addressed this at length, plagiarism is not okay, you need to provide sources of credit. Boom. That's it. That's all you have to say. And the vast majority of people have been really nice and sharing my video and everything, but there's just been a few that were. So normally I make my videos so that anyone watching, even if you're not familiar with the thing I'm talking about, can still follow the video, but that is not the case for this video. I'm going to assume you have watched or read all of these things going into this video. So I'll kind of go through them rapid fire. Part one of my Ateez Color Theory video. Literally nothing about this video is going to make sense unless you have watched my first video. I'm going to talk about every Ateez music video, concept photos, especially Fever 2 concept photos, the diary film, which is like, how do I explain the diary film? It's sort of like the core of Ateez's fictional universe storyline. It's this short film that was put out during pre-promotions for Fever 1. The diary entries. So for all of Fever, they released 3 different versions of the albums. And if you buy the diary version of the album, you get like a big chunk of the story included as part of the packaging. If you're familiar with the way BTS does their storyline and you know what the notes are, it's the same kind of thing. I call them the diary entries because that's definitely what they are. like their first person accounts from each of the members being like, this is what happened to me in the story. But people have uploaded scans of them on Twitter, so I'll put a link below if you haven't read them yet and you want to. These are kind of the only 2 things you need for the universe storyline, which from here on out I'm going to call the diary storyline. There have been other diary-related things like live performances and whatnot, but this is all you need for my video, and this is really like the base of the story. And then probably the most obscure thing on this list is their 2022 world tour announcement. This was like a 1-minute video, like a promotional video put out a month ago or something, announcing their world tour for the fellowship. And I'm going to bring up this video a lot, so it would be helpful if you have seen it, but it's just a short little promotional video put out by KQ. So that's the introduction out of the way, and now we can actually start. Hooray. I'm so excited. Alrighty, yellow and green. So this was the thing I got a million questions about. Everybody was freaking out. How did you figure out yellow and green during Treasure? Well, I hate to break it to you. I'm not a genius. It's not that hard. And I'm going to show you how I figured it out. So looking at Treasure, a lot of people can get on board with yellow. Lots of people are like, okay, I see yellow. To the point that I've actually seen quite a few theories written that Ateez actually follows a 3 color scheme with red, blue, and yellow, which are the primary colors. And these people think that at some point we're going to switch to the secondary colors or the tertiary colors, or maybe we already have. I don't agree with this theory. I don't agree with this theory for several reasons. One, yellow and green, but yellow, don't show up in their lyrics during Treasure, which I think is really important. And then two, I just think that if they were going to use a three color scheme, they would have used the colors equally. And you just can't look at anything released in Treasure and deny the fact that red and blue are so much more prominent than yellow. So I don't think it's a three color scheme. I think the colors come in pairs, and you have red and blue, and they have a connection, and yellow and green, and they go together. Green is just as common as yellow. You just don't notice it as much. First, you're going to see when we go through examples, for whatever reason, just the way things turned out, they ended up using yellow a lot for big title track music videos, and green was used more for B-side music videos or like Japanese releases. So I think that the music videos that people were watching a lot were more likely to have yellow. The second thing is Treasure 3, One to All. They used yellow in a whole bunch of promotional content for One to All, and there was never really a comeback, during Treasure at least, where they used green in the same way. So I think this sort of threw a lot of people off and made people think that yellow was more important than it was. And then the last reason you don't notice green, which is a tragedy in my opinion, is that green shows up a lot as trees and plants and grass. And when you're watching a music video and you see trees, your initial reaction is not, hey, that's a green thing that is in this music video on purpose to be green. Your reaction is like, ah, that's some nice scenery and some nice nature. And then it fades into the back of your mind and you never think about it again. But make no mistake, trees are green. Groundbreaking facts you learn here at the Tiny Bug. Trees are green. But really, the color of plants matters. So this is just a little warm-up example. This is a shot of Wooyoung from Wave. And we know, during Treasure, everything is red and blue, all the time. Clothes, makeup, lighting, everything. Like, the thing I always think about, there's this establishing shot of Yeonho and Wave, and he has blue hair, he's in a red car, and you have whatever, like the sky or the ocean behind him that's blue. And if you look, hanging from the rearview mirror, there's this little charm thing. That's red and blue. like they put a lot of effort into this. They go out of their way to make things red and blue. So why, in God's name, are Wooyoung's earrings green? Is it hard to find red or blue earrings? No, it's not hard. You know how I know it's not hard? Wooyoung, he has red earrings in Eternal Sunshine. San has blue earrings in Aurora. Hongjoon has red earrings in Aurora. We see members with red and blue earrings all the time. So this is wrong, right? This is wrong. It doesn't match the established red-blue pattern. And it's wrong on purpose. Treasure 1, all to 0. So I tend to give all to 0 a little bit of a pass when it comes to color theory stuff, because quite frankly, KQ didn't have a lot of money when they made these music videos, so I'm sure they didn't necessarily have the resources to make the music videos that they wanted to make. There's definitely color theory stuff in here, but it's a little less strict in following it than the other comebacks. And there is still yellow and green in All to Zero. So we have San, who has like green hair during this era. You could definitely interpret this as blue. It's a little bit questionable. And then Treasure, there's a whole bunch of stuff. We have this architecture. I don't know what to call this. Yeonho wears yellow. It looks very yellow in this shot, but he's actually wearing like yellow and blue gingham. We have Sunghwa, who's wearing yellow. Yeonho, again, in green. Hongjun has yellow stripes in his shirt. Mingy has like yellow splotches in his jacket. And then all of this stuff that takes place in the garden. 0 to 1. So, you know, when you watch Hala Hala and you like skip through the introduction section at the beginning to get to the actual music video, don't lie, we all do this, it's fine, but you probably shouldn't do that because they're wearing yellow. We have San in yellow, Wooyoung in yellow, Mingy's wearing yellow, Hongjun is also wearing yellow. It's hard to tell, but I'm pretty sure Jungho and Yoseong also wear yellow. You kind of have to look at the behind the scenes to figure out what everybody's wearing. And then we get close-up shots of the megaphone, which is obviously predominantly red and blue, but there is yellow and green on it as well. And I'm sure somebody else has done a lot of theorizing about what the microphone stickers say. I'm not going to do that. Moving on. Say My Name is Fun. This is your homework after you watch this video, is to go watch the Say My Name music video, because everything in Say My Name is red and blue. Everything. All the time. Or black and white, but mostly red and blue. Everything in Say My Name is red and blue. And if you watch that music video and you know what you're looking for, it stands out so much. There is only one thing in the Say My Name music video that is not red or blue, and it's their name tags. So we get close-up shots of Hongjun's here. This is Wooyoung, and he has like green boxes. Hongjun also wears this like peacock earring, which again, questionable turquoise color. This could be blue, this could be green, follow your heart. And then we don't get close-up shots of anybody else's name tag really in the music video except for Sanghwa, but his name tag is red and blue. So to see everybody else's name tags, you have to look at the Say My Name concept photos because they have close-ups. So Yeonho has yellow here, Jungho has yellow, San has yellow, and then his name is written in like green ink. So that's Say My Name. One to all. My one true love. I'm going to talk about One to All today probably more than I'm going to talk about Fever. And there's a very specific reason for that, which is that I see One to All as like the origin place of yellow and green. This is the first point in which yellow and green show up in a significant way, and I think really have meaning, like a decent amount of meaning tied to those colors. And so in my opinion, to talk about yellow and green in Fever and beyond, you have to be able to tie it back to something from One to All, because this is the origin place of yellow and green. So start with Wave. There's all kinds of stuff in this bedroom. We have this like yellow blanket, this plant in the background. You have the yellow stripes and Jungho's shirt. You have San and this like yellow sweater vest, these yellow and green pillows. In this outfit, Hongjun wears quite a bit of yellow. And specifically on his jacket are like yellow flowers. You can put a pin in that. We're going to talk about flowers later. Mingy wears this outfit with the green stripes, and then with the color shift at the end during like sunset and everything, a whole bunch of members wear yellow or green. So you have Yeonho, you have San, you have Hongjun, Jungho. Mingy's wearing yellow too, you just can't see it. His shoes, you have Sungwon in these like green gingham pants. And then trees. So many trees and plants in Wave. If you think there is no green in Wave, you need to go watch that music video again. There are plants or trees in almost every single shot of the Wave music video, and even like several scenes where it's just like only the plants, like that's the whole scene. There's a lot of green in Wave. A footnote about Wave: in the grocery store scenes, Yeonho is like playing with fruit, and he's holding yellow fruit. like he has a yellow apple and a banana. I don't know if this is intentional. In the behind the scenes, it does seem like they just grab random food to play with. So that's maybe one as well. And then a second footnote: they've said in interviews that Yeonho was supposed to have green hair during this era, during One to All, and they had to dye it blue because of the green screen in Illusion. It caused all kinds of problems. Now, that is very interesting and very intriguing, but I think we should go with Yunho has blue hair in this era. Like, blue hair is canon. That's what actually ends up happening, so that is what we should go with. But it is cool to think about. Illusion. So, Wave has a whole bunch of green in it. Illusion has a whole bunch of yellow in it. They are opposites of each other. So, the ending scene on the island where everything's purple, you have Yunho in yellow, you have Sun in yellow, and like, guys, like, look at this detail. Like, the cuff of his sleeve has red and blue and yellow stripes. Ugh. I love it. I love it so much. I love to see it. Jungho is also wearing yellow in this set of outfits as part of, like, the lettering of his shirt. Yoseng wears kind of the most yellow. I do think Yoseng has a interesting and significant relationship with yellow. Almost everybody wears yellow in this music video, with the exception of Sunghwa and Hongjun. Jungho also wears yellow in this outfit. It's like part of the collar of his jacket. Sun is wearing yellow, and it's part of the lettering of his shirt. And then Woo Young wears yellow stripes here. And then Mingi, I don't know why they did this. I've watched this music video a whole bunch of times, and I'm like 100% sure Mingi wears two different pairs of plaid pants. So the first pair is these ones, which are red and blue, and they have like green stripes going through them. And these are the ones he wears in the concept photos. And then on the boat, he wears these ones that are definitely yellow. Everything else about his outfit and his styling is exactly the same. They just changed like one piece of his clothing. And they did this with San too, where he wears this shirt in the tent and he wears like the salmon colored shirt on the boat. I don't know why they did this, if like it was just like things that had more problems with the green screen, like the green stripe in these pants couldn't be on the boat, or if there's like a reason behind it. I don't know if they've ever talked about it, so if you have thoughts as to like why they would do this, let me know. Aurora. Love Aurora. So I do want to stress, Aurora is a red-blue song. It's a red-blue music video. It's on a red-blue album. It's during a red-blue era, which is Treasure. And this is what a lot of Aurora looks like. You have the blue sky with like the pink horizon and the water down here that's blue. And I'm pretty sure they chose this location because the red rust on this tent. You have everybody dressed in red and blue. So Mingi has red and blue stripes. Sun has red and blue stripes. Yunho, who you can't see, has red and blue stripes. They give Yoseng these adorable bright red sneakers. Okay, this is my favorite thing to come out of Ateez Color Theory, is when they give members like really adorable, brightly colored sneakers. It happens here, it happens in Eternal Sunshine, it happens in Wave. I hope they never stop. This is my favorite thing. Please keep doing this. Anyways, there's definitely red and blue in Aurora, but a lot of Aurora looks like this. There's a shit ton of green in Aurora. And like, I want to emphasize, this is intentional. Like, this is on purpose. There are so many things they could have done to make this music video not green. Like, they could have filmed the whole music video on the bridge. They could have framed the shots like they do in Wave, where you see like the majority of the sky and just a little bit of trees at the bottom. They could have thrown a whole bunch of color grading on the music video to make the trees look more blue. They could have shot in front of red and blue flowers or something. I mean, like, there's literally a red tree right here that they could have shot this music video in front of, and they didn't. No. These trees are green, and they're green on purpose, and they're in this music video intentionally as a green thing. This is intentional. And of course, we know that green trees are important because this happens. These are a part of Fever 2 concept photos. They're the Fever 2 triptychs. If you don't know what a triptych is, I made a whole video about it. They're basically like the Long Boy concept photos. So these ones came from Fever 2. And I'm going to talk about these a lot. There's like 14 layers to these photos. So if I say Fever 2 triptychs. I'm talking about these concept photos with the trees. And given the importance of green trees in Aurora, I do think that, at least symbolically, this tree is the Aurora tree. Like, they're the same. Other green in Aurora, Wooyoung wears green. It's kind of hard to see. It's, like, on his sleeve here. And then Hongjin actually wears green. I don't remember if it was, like, a fan sign or a V-Live or something. There's some fan event, I'm pretty sure, where he tie-dyes a t-shirt, and he tie-dyes it blue and green, and then he wears it in this music video underneath this, like, white sweater. So, Hongjin is actually wearing green as well. Episode Finn, all to action. So, episode, EP Finn. I always do that. All to action. I see all to action and Wonderland as being kind of like the finale of Red and Blue. Like, this is the ultimate showdown of Red and Blue. And I definitely think, like, Wonderland is the easiest music video to pick up on color theory stuff. It's definitely the music video where I first noticed it, because you have, like, bright primary red and a lot of it, and you have bright primary blue and a lot of it. And so it makes sense to me that during this comeback, given that that's what this EP is, or album, I guess it's a full album, that Red and Blue, or Yellow and Green, kind of take a back seat to Red and Blue during this era. But there is Yellow and Green in Wonderland. You have this light in Yeonho's scenes, which, again, could be blue, could be green. Sort of questionable. And then all these plants in San scenes with the flowers and such. Shift the map. Okay, so this was the Japanese album where we got the music video for Utopia. Now, Utopia was originally released on One to All, so I do think a lot of the conversations we're going to have about Utopia are probably more relevant and more related to One to All than just this, like, Japanese album that they put out. Where is the green in Utopia? Wooyoung is wearing it. There's lots of theories written about Wooyoung. And he deserves it, because he's the best. I'm biased. But no, really. He's definitely a very unique character in the diary storyline, and I also think he's pretty unique color theory-wise. I consider Wooyoung to be the most blue member. Now, he does wear red, more so in Fever than in Treasure. He's red in Thanks, and he's, like, half red in Eternal Sunshine. He wears red in Answer. His, like, white fuzzy sweater has, like, the tiniest stripes of red in it. And Say My Name, his, like, tan fur jacket. That's Wooyoung's red, because the red of Say My Name is very maroonish brown. But even then, he's wearing, like, the lightest possible shade of red. Wooyoung is the only member who's never had red hair. And he does wear blue a lot, especially compared to the other members. But he also wears black a lot, which is, like, the other side. And I do think Wooyoung wears quite a bit of green, and sort of starts wearing green before everyone else. Like, he wears green all throughout Treasure. I don't know if there's a reason for this, or if it's just meant to be, like, or if it's actually meant to be part of his character arc, or if his stylists think he just looks better in darker colors, which they're right. Thank you. But yeah, if someone wanted to write a theory or, like, a very long, thorough analysis of everything Wooyoung has ever worn, I would read that. Or any member, but mostly Wooyoung. The epilogue. So far, what both of the epilogues have been is kind of looks back. They're almost like the epilogue for Treasure is almost like a summary of the whole series. And so, again, if Treasure is Red and Blue, the series itself, the epilogue is going to be predominantly based on Red and Blue. So yet another sort of comeback where Yellow and Green take a back seat, and Red and Blue are much more emphasized. But you do have green in Answer. These curtains, these goddamn curtains, are green. Now, listen, Listen, I've watched this music video a lot of times, and I know in certain shots of this music video, these curtains don't look green. They look like golden. But I promise you, these curtains are green. They really are. And again, this is intentional. Like, this is on purpose. I'm pretty sure they built this set. I could be wrong. Like, maybe this is, like, a location they went and shot at. But even if that's true, is it hard to get red or blue curtains? No, it's not hard. You know how I know it's not hard? They have blue curtains in Wave. So, these curtains are green. Prove me wrong. No. Map to answer. This was another Japanese release. We didn't get new music videos for this, but we did get new concept photos, and this is what those look like. So obviously, predominantly red and blue concept photos, but even here, you have Yosang with a little bit of green, you have green in the stripes of San's plaid, there's yellow in the stripes of Hongjun's plaid, and there's yellow in like Yosang's sweater. So you kind of have to look at their individual concept photos to see close-ups of what they're wearing. But even here, they have slipped in like the tiniest amount of yellow and green. So I say in my first video, everything Ateez has ever released is red and blue, and that's a little bit of a lie. 99% of what they released during Treasure was red and blue, but there was always this small amount that wasn't. When I was doing my quote-unquote research for my first color theory video, I basically just watched every single Ateez music video in order about 9 million times. And I kept track of everything that was red and blue. Like, I had a whole notes section of my phone dedicated to tracking it. And what happens when you do that, when you start paying a lot of attention to when things are red and blue, it starts to become glaringly obvious when something isn't red and blue. And every time something wasn't red or blue, it was yellow or green. So my one and only thought as to why they were slipping tiny amounts of yellow and green into everything was that they were breadcrumbs, like little hints for the next colors. That is how I came to that conclusion. I really just watched the music videos a lot. I think kind of the big takeaway and my main advice would be to look a little bit bigger picture. Like KQ is really not fucking around. Like, they're playing the long game. And I think it's easy to get pigeonholed and want one poster or one live performance or just like one thing to contain all the spoilers for what's coming next. And that doesn't really seem to be the way they're doing things. So this is a good example. This was a social media post they made between Treasure and Fever coming out, and everybody was like, oh, the colors of the albums match their microphones. That means these are the next colors for the next comeback. And then that definitely didn't happen. And it really just turned out to be an ordinary picture of their microphones. Although I do think it's interesting that they put red and blue opposite each other. But anyways, I also see this all the time with hair color. And believe me, like, I'm a fan. I get excited when new hair colors drop. But I always see, like, these big, long theories people write, like, Sangwa, he has red hair. That means he's evil now. Like, hair color is important and definitely a part of it, but it is not the only important thing. I think hair color should be taken into account along with everything else. What are they wearing in the music video? If they have more than one outfit, is one more red and one more blue? What do their solo scenes look like? Their concept photos, etc. So, like, Hongjun and Aurora has red hair and red earrings, but everything else he's wearing is blue and green and white and his whole setting and everything. So Hongjun is not red in this music video, or at least not entirely red. So yeah, that's my little soapbox about the big picture, but whatever, you don't have to listen to me. Follow your heart. What does it all mean? What do yellow and green mean? Well, I have some thoughts. Part of the reason, though, that this isn't getting an official video essay is that I am less confident about everything I'm going to say in this video. With my first video, I was like, yes, this is a thing. I am right about this. But much less so here. So take everything with a grain of salt. If you have different thoughts about yellow and green, feel free to let me know. I do definitely think we get this split, where you have yellow over here with red, and you have green over here on the side of blue. And you can tell this even just from Treasure. Like, you don't even need to look at Fever, because red music videos will have yellow in them. So Holla Holla is a red music video, it has yellow in it. Illusion is a red music video, has yellow in it. And the same is true on the other side, right? So Aurora is like the ultimate example of a blue music video, and it has a bunch of green in it. I do think we get this grouping of colors into two separate categories. And I previously labeled these categories as evil and good. But because of a lot of things that have happened, especially with the diary storyline, I don't think evil and good are particularly accurate or good terms to use for these categories anymore, and I'll elaborate more on that in a sec. I don't think that yellow and green mean the exact same thing as red and blue, because if they're just going to mean the exact same thing, like, there would be no reason for KQ to change the colors. So I think yellow and green mean something related to red and blue, something similar, but different. I say this in my first color theory video. A lot of their lyrics reference metaphorical opposites, such as the desert and the sky, hot and cold, day and night, awake and asleep. And I'm going to talk about this a lot, so if I say hot and cold, day and night for the rest of this video, I'm talking about this whole idea of metaphorical opposites that represent these colors. And I previously put awake and asleep on this list, but I want to scratch awake and asleep from the red and blue list, because I don't think awake and asleep are red and blue things. I think they're yellow and green things. And I also think they're swapped. So you have yellow over here with red, and I think asleep belongs with yellow. And you have green over here with blue, and I think awake belongs with green. This is my take on what yellow and green mean. Yellow is asleep, and green is awake. And this kind of goes back to the duality of dreams. So yellow is dreams you have while you're asleep. So you go to bed, you close your eyes, and you have dreams. And those dreams are imaginary, right? They show you an illusion. And all of this is contrasted with dreams you have while you're awake. So your goals, the things you want to accomplish, you follow your dreams. And those happen and take place in reality. And this is sort of what I mean when I say to talk about yellow and green, you have to go back to one to all, because this is all very much a part of the duality between wave and illusion. So both of these music videos, Wave and Illusion, they start in the exact same way. Both of these music videos start with everyone asleep. Now, we get shots in Wave of everybody waking up. And they're in reality with the green plants and everything. In Illusion, we don't see anyone wake up. Like, it's not a part of the music video. So everything that happens in Illusion happens while they're asleep. They're having a dream. It's an illusion, hence the title of the music video. They're not in reality. Everything that takes place and happens in Illusion is in a dream. I also think this is supported by the diary storyline. Just like we see in Illusion, it is heavily implied in the diary entries that everything that happens, like the whole plot in Strickland, is a dream. Like they're asleep and this other dimension is a dream that they're having. And we get parts of the diary entries where members will like suddenly wake up and they're back in reality, in the hideout or whatever. So back to the two color categories. Instead of using evil and good, I think it's much more accurate to think of these two groups of colors as belonging to the two different dimensions. So in the dream dimension, you have the black pirates and Halahala Ateez and sort of the red dystopian wasteland of Strickland. And there's this whole thing in the diary entries about the yellow smoke of Strickland, which is like a hallucinogenic. Breathing in the smoke causes you to enter this dream state where you experience illusions. You see things that aren't real. And then you have all of these other colors that exist, vice versa, in the reality dimension. So you have like the normal version of Ateez in reality. And the words that they use to describe these two dimensions are the new world and the old world. So I think of these now as new world colors versus old world colors, and not evil and good. Because like Halahala Ateez and the Black Pirates aren't necessarily evil. Like, they're anarchists. It's different. I mean, they might really turn out to be evil in the future, but right now in the story, they're like the good guys. A note on plants. Plants are really flipping important, in my opinion. Every time I see a plant in an Ateez music video, I lose my goddamn mind. So based on all of this, Wave takes place in reality. And all of the plants in Wave are green. All of them. Green, 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 green. We love to see it. We love it. Now, if we think about a dream world or dimension, plants might not be green. They might be just like any old color that your brain can come up with, which is what we see in Illusion, where none of the plants are green. So you get like the multicolored palm trees and the flowers, which we're going to talk about flowers in a sec. And then all of these plants at the end, which technically are green, but they have all these like lights pointed at them to make them look not green. So in reality, plants are green. In an illusion, plants are not green. Which is super, super, duper interesting when we look at Fever 2 concept photos, where you have all of these plants in the background that are half painted, multicolored, and half green. Half painted, half green. Half painted, half green. Half painted, half green. Half painted, half green. This leaf is painted, so this leaf is green. This leaf is painted, so this leaf is green. It's literally all of them. So we already know that Fever 2, and in fact all of Fever, deals with this confusing intermixing of reality and illusion. And you can tell this just based off the color of the plants and the concept photos. It's so good. It's so good. I love it so much. Now let's talk about flowers. I think you could go with, okay, you have like the yellow or multicolored flowers and the green stems. So same kind of thing as the painted plants, mixing of reality and illusion. Right now, I kind of believe that flowers, no matter what they look like, always represent illusion. Every time they bring up flowers in their lyrics, they're almost always talked about within the context of utopia, like this magical, lush land with flowers, and utopia is part of New World, and it's an illusion. And there's this whole subplot in the diary storyline with Left Eye's daughter, and she dies. Kind of morbid. She dies, and in her place blooms a flower. And because of the yellow smoke of Strickland, Left Eye keeps, like, seeing her alive, but she's not alive at that point. He's hallucinating her. So given that she is an illusion after her death, and she's associated with flowers after her death, flowers equal illusion, always. Maybe this will change, I don't know. Back to this Fever 2 triptych. So here we have, like, the green tree with all the, like, multicolored flowers, AO, mixing of reality and illusion. And then we get the dead tree, right? See, both have gone up in smoke. Bad things can happen and do happen in both dimensions. Neither is safe. Be afraid. Your dreams can also be your nightmares. So I really think the color of plants matters. It matters here. It matters in Eternal Sunshine concept photos. You might want to go take a look at those again, because that grass is not green. It's multicolored. It matters in One to All. And I also think, like, Wonderland, where you have Sun with all the grass and, like, flowers around him. That's interesting. This is my take on yellow and green, and this is a little bit of a summary. So red and blue as the two sides of ambition. I, me, mine, those are all red words, versus we, us, ours, those are all blue words. And there's even, like, a line in Yelsang's Fever 1 diary entry where he says something like, I became ours. So that's kind of cool. And then there are lots, but the big primary representations we see for these colors in lyrics and music videos and stuff is the desert being a red thing versus the sky or the ocean being a blue thing. And then yellow and green being the two sides of dreams. Dreams you have while you're asleep versus dreams you have while you're awake, being in an illusion versus being in reality, and the color of plants. And this is why I say yellow and green represent something similar to red and blue, but different. Because ambitions and dreams, they're the same thing. I mean, those words are, like, direct synonyms of each other. This is just two different ways to talk about the same thing. So I make my prediction that yellow and green were going to be the next colors. And then these posters were the very first thing that was released for Fever, and I was so happy. I really was. But I was also a little bit wrong. I thought that Treasure was going to be red and blue, and then they were going to completely stop doing red and blue, and Fever was going to be completely yellow and green, which is definitely not what happened. Fever is more of a transitionary series. I think about Fever as sort of being like the handoff between red and blue and yellow and green. And I'm going to talk about this more later when we go over spectrums and gradients, but I still really feel like we haven't fully gotten a yellow-green series yet. My predictions for the future, well, I think one of two things is going to happen. I think number one is more likely. Either one, Treasure is red and blue. Fever is the handoff between red and blue and yellow and green, the transition. The next series will be entirely yellow and green, and then we'll get another transitional series and then new colors. That's what I think is going to happen. Option two is that they are adding, like, two new colors for every series. So Treasure is red and blue. Fever is red and blue plus yellow and green, and the next series will be red, blue, yellow, green plus two more colors. But I think if Fever was supposed to be the yellow-green era, they would have put more yellow-green in it than they did. And so I still really think yellow-green series is coming. I want this to happen so badly. I just want Woo-young with green hair, okay? I want Woo-young with green hair. Like, I really do. Like, dark green, evergreen colored hair. He would look so nice. I really want this. I think I deserve this. Woo-young with green hair would be great. It would be legendary. Anyways. So, I see these posters as really showing us more of what the end of Fever looks like rather than the beginning, which is why they match the concept photos from the epilogue. Because for Ateez, the beginning is the end is the beginning, it's a cycle, that whole thing. These posters are hints not just for Fever 1, but for Fever Epilogue, the end of Fever, and for the beginning of the next cycle. So what are the next colors? Now, the next series is going to be yellow and green. I really believe in this. And then after that, we will get new colors introduced. If you follow me on Twitter, you might already know what I think the next colors are going to be. I think they're going to be orange and purple. Now, I could definitely be wrong about this. I don't really have a lot to go on at this point, and both of these colors are difficult for different reasons. Purple is hard because purple has sort of already been established as the middle ground of red and blue. So right now, when you see purple in a music video, is that purple as a combination of red and blue, or is that purple as breadcrumbs for a future era? There is literally no way to tell. I think if we do end up switching to a yellow-green era and they continue to use purple in content past the point where they stop using red and blue, that would confirm this up a little bit more. And then orange is annoying for different reasons, which is that it's just really hard to differentiate orange from red in music videos. I say in my first video that they use new shades of red and blue for every music video. And a lot of shades of red that they have used have been very orangey, brownish, tan, maroon. This happens in Dreamers, in Answer, and Say My Name. Don't even get me started on Thanks. And like, this is the point for me where it's like 2 a.m. and I'm watching a music video frame by frame trying to decide if sand should be categorized as red or orange. And I'm always like, oh my god, this is why I'm single. Like, do you ever have those like brief moments of clarity? I sure do. But it's okay. That's what keeps us humble. Anyways, so yeah, that's why orange sucks. But I don't think I'm wrong about this, and here's my explanation for why. One, we have gotten a light sprinkling of orange and purple things in Ateez content so far. And the other reason I think this is going to happen is because it completes the color wheel. So right now we have red and blue, and they have a connection, and yellow and green, and they have a connection. So the last two colors to complete the color wheel are orange and purple, and for them to go together. Beyond getting orange and purple, we won't really get any new colors because we will have all the colors, but we might get new combinations like a yellow-blue era or like a purple-yellow era or something. But that's a prediction like 15 comebacks into the future, so I don't even know if that's gonna happen. If we get orange and purple, we will also end up with this very nice and convenient split in the color wheel where warm colors will be New World colors, and cool colors will be Old World colors, which other people have pointed this out, so I'm definitely not the first. I think especially with them changing up the colors and using different shades of colors for each comeback, I think we are eventually headed towards this point of them completing the color wheel. We start with black and white in Intro Long Journey at the very beginning of Treasure Series. And then Pirate King adds in those flashes of red. So Pirate King adds red, and then we steadily add more and more colors until all the way in the distant future where we reach this point where Ateez will have used every shade of every color, and it will be beautiful. That's where I think we are going. So this idea of completing the color wheel, I think, is also very relevant to Aurora. I did a crappy job of underlining that. Aurora. I'm obsessed with Aurora, and I kind of don't understand why everyone isn't obsessed with Aurora. Like, everyone writes theories about Hala Hala and Answer, but I think there is so much important stuff going on in Aurora that gets completely overlooked. So I'm here today to change your mind about Aurora. So part of the opening lyrics of Aurora is this line, various colors in front of my eyes, and it's sometimes translated as every color in front of my eyes. And what this song talks about is Hongjun being on tour, on stage, and seeing this great big aurora of light and color, seeing the audience from the stage. And I think kind of the point is that even the most red music video is not 100% red. Even the most blue member is not 100% blue. People really want to put things into boxes, but nobody is ever just one thing. Like, we are all special and unique colors, and we all change over time. And when we are together, we are every color. Like, that's the whole baseline message of so much Ateez content. So starting from black and white and moving towards this point of celebrating and embracing every color. And we get the Fellowship World Tour announcement where, like, this exact same thing happens. So you have black and white, that kind of then this bleeding effect of the rainbow covers everything. Oh, yeah, okay, yeah, I forgot about this. All right, so a lot of people are annoyed that we don't have official colors for Ateez, but I sort of think this is, like, the reason why. Like, if they're doing all of this, of course they're not going to assign us, like, one color. And I think it's kind of for a beautiful reason, so I'm not mad about it. Honestly, the real reason people want official colors is so that you know which colored heart emoji you should use, or, like, what color you should wear to concerts. So my advice is to just use all of the heart emojis, all of them, the whole rainbow. Or you know, stick with yellow and green, because we're trying to manifest that. We're trying to make that happen. I think you should wear whatever color you look best in to go to an Ateez concert. That is what they would want. That's what I think. Alrighty, so that's the end of all of those, and we're going to move on to the next slides. Okay, I'm going to go through all of the Fever music videos and talk about the colors in them. I'm hopefully going to do this kind of fast, because if you watched my first color theory video and you have eyeballs, you can probably tell for yourself what colors they are, but this is just so we're all on the same page about what happens in Fever and how I think of these music videos. I'm going to be bringing up color shifts. So color shifts in music videos are just dramatic changes in color. They usually happen in, like, the third chorus. Painting the camera red at the end of Hala Hala is, like, the most obvious example of a color shift, but sometimes they're a little more subtle. So Inception is basically just a continuation of the diary film. It's red and blue. This lovely person on Twitter, Snow Sunshine, she made this massive thread where she breaks down in detail all of the red and blue in Inception. So I don't even need to talk about this music video, because her analysis is better than anything I could have ever come up with. You should go read it. It will be linked below. Inception is red and blue. We get a color shift to red. Sort of what scenes in this music video are red and blue depend on the member, because a lot of this is solo scenes. We do get a little bit of yellow green, the shop, and there's little things in Yeonho's set, like this and this and this and this is green. Tiny bit of green sprinkled throughout. And then these TV screens, these could be like red and blue, or you could think of them as yellow and green. Up to you. Ugh. Thanks. Thanks is so confusing to me. Like, I understand the lyrics, but not this music video. It doesn't make any sense to me from a color theory perspective. I keep waiting for something to come out that makes Thanks make sense to me, and it hasn't happened. So if you have ideas about Thanks, go for it, because I'm at a loss. All the promotional content was yellow and green, so I thought we were going to get a yellow-green music video, and that's definitely not what this is. We get a yellow-green title card and Thanks written in green here, but there's not that much else that's green in this music video, like the grass under the bus, but it's not a lot. This yellow school bus, which is like a major set piece, these school uniform outfits, they're wearing navy blue. These Burberry outfits have like red stripes in them, and you have some members in more red, like Wooyoung here is like half red. This, I guess you have kind of like red below and like blue above. This color of the flag, this like neon salmon color, what the hell is this? Is it orange? Is it red? I'm gonna go with this color being red, but I understand why a lot of the conversation about this color, people are saying that it's orange. So whatever it is, it's obnoxious. This rug set is probably the most confusing to me, because you literally have every color here and you have members dressed in every color. You just have all this like hanging fabric and these, I don't know what to call these like wind sock things. If you know the name of these, tell me what they are. I don't know what is going on here. We do get a color shift to red, and Ateez is written here in yellow. This camo print is sort of like all the New World colors, because it's like red and yellow and black, like all together. You get the like red versus blue smoke bombs and the red versus blue cars and this like green light down here. But like all the stuff on this rig that they're on, it's all the same stuff, hanging stuff from the rug set. Like they're the same. What is this supposed to be? Is this meant to be like the island? I've seen a lot of people talk about this as like being Skull Island from like Peter Pan. I don't know if I believe in that, but like what the hell is this? What is going on? So that's Thanks. Yeah. Fireworks is very red. Back to things that make sense. Fireworks is very red. We get a red title card. So much red in this music video and red outfits and everything. And we almost get a color shift in Fireworks, but it's like from red to more red, you know, like the ending here, where everything like goes crazy. We get a little bit of blue, especially in Yeonho's scenes with the sky. I'm going to talk about the sky in a later set of PowerPoints, so I'm just going to point it out a lot in these music videos. These outfits are pretty blue, with the exception of Yeonho, who's wearing like all black, and we get some shots of the train that are blue. There's a lot of yellow in Fireworks, but it's hard to like capture in screenshots. It's all this like hazy yellow light, which of course is meant to be the yellow smoke of Strickland, because they're on New World in this music video. And you have some members in yellow, like Wooyoung. Jungkook has yellow on in the concept photos, but I don't think he wears it here, so I don't know why they did that. Celebrate. A lot of people have probably never even seen this music video. It was like a special little fun additional video they put out. It's barely a music video. It's blue. Everything I'm gonna say, it's just filmed in the same set as the concept photos, so everything I have to say about this set of concept photos applies to the Celebrate music video. We get a blue title card, makes sense. Weirdly, we do get a color shift in Celebrate because I didn't do this. This is what the music video looks like. They just put this like red tint over the last quarter of it. It's kind of funny. So there's a color shift to red in Celebrate. Dreamers. I love Dreamers. Love Dreamers. Dreamers is like the first music where I'm like, yes, this is green. This is green. And all the plants and the trees and the grass of Dreamers is green. Ah, we love to see it. Plants. Lots of the sky, which is blue for especially Songhwa scenes. These outfits, they're kind of wearing like a combination of black and navy blue. They paint this canvas with blue and red and yellow. Somebody else can do some analysis on what all of this says. I'm not going to. We get a color shift in Dreamers to blue. It's almost like the opposite of the Holo Holo color shift where Wooyoung like paints the camera blue. Now it's a color shift to blue and a little bit red. It's like blue and red, but the red is like in parentheses. The red of Dreamers is like this sandy brown color. This is red. Yelsang is actually kind of like the only one wearing blue in these scenes. We get this like pink stuff at sunset, this scarf that's like blue and purple and red and white stripes. We get a blue and white title card. That makes sense. This shot at the end where they're all asleep is interesting because all the plants in Dreamers are green, so they're asleep here. Kind of peculiar. We'll talk about that later, don't worry. Why they're asleep in reality. Anyways, this blanket has flowers. Hey, yeah. The flowers are kind of yellow and red and white. And then all the other blankets are like blue and white. And this is basically like a recreation of the shot in Utopia where they're just laying on the ground. Black Cat Narrow is red and black. Yelsang drinks red wine like a boss. There's a little bit of green. There's like these inverse flashes that happen and some green grass in the graveyard. Be My Lover is just equal parts red, blue, yellow, green. I don't really have that much to say about this music video. I mean, green plants, you know I love it. But it's just a fun, cute little music video. I don't think there's a lot of meaning in this music video, but prove me wrong. A Little Space. I don't count A Little Bit of Space. I consider this a Pentatonix music video, not an Ateez music video, but if you wanted to count it, Sun in red and black, Jungho in red and black, Yeonho in green and red, their backgrounds are blue and red and purple and kind of a color shift to purple. I'm going to talk about like the moon and the stars and stuff later. I don't think any of this counts towards my theory. This is all just a pun on the word space, so this entire music video is filmed in outer space. If you want to count this, go for it, but I am not going to for the rest of this video. Deja Vu is blue, so Fireworks Fever 2 is red and yellow, so Fever 3 is the opposite. You have blue for Deja Vu and kind of the green and Eternal Sunshine, so all the promotional stuff for Deja Vu is blue and black versus the green and white of Eternal Sunshine. So much blue in Eternal Sunshine, or so much blue in Deja Vu. A little bit of red here and there, some smoke and lighting and Hyungjin's hair, which we're going to talk about in a sec, don't worry. A little bit of yellow and green here and there. Green. These butterflies, which I can't really decide if they're blue or green. I kind of think they're green, but everybody talks about them being blue, so maybe I'm wrong. They obviously match the blue butterflies from Answer and Dancing Like Butterfly Wings. I mean, we could have an interesting conversation about whether that song was blue or red. I consider it a mostly blue song, so butterflies are blue. And then this scene, which is like my favorite, it's like perfect. You have yellow, you have green, you have Wooyoung in blue, you have the red flowers. It's everything I'm obsessed with in one shot. Eternal Sunshine. You have, right, Eternal Sunshine, all the promotional content, green and white. You have the green title card against the white of the like clouds in the sky. The sky is blue. And it's written in green here. Eternal Sunshine is a little bit all over the place too, but it doesn't confuse me in the same way that Thanks does. We get the all these green plants in that fill the train. Now, I don't count this as a color shift because it doesn't affect every single set. It's like just the train set that turns green. It's like a baby color shift, but it's not like a full color shift. Some white and green on the train even before it the color shift. The sort of green plants here and sort of every color in the tennis court set. You have like the pink standing in for red versus blue. You have yellow and green and then orange, which we're going to talk about in a sec, don't worry, and the same red and blue pipes, orange wall, yellow wall, a little bit of green sprinkled throughout. So Eternal Sunshine, Spotless Mind, Eternal Sunshine, the Ateez music video is based on this movie. Or it draws a lot from this movie. And there is color theory stuff in this movie, with the color of Clementine's hair and the memories of her, the stage of the relationship and the seasons and all that. A lot of people have written theories connecting all of this to Ateez, especially with Hongjun having orange hair during this comeback. I don't really have anything unique to add to that conversation. It's easy to find theories about this if you want to read some. I do think it introduces some unique ideas about what these colors potentially mean. But I see all the orange that shows up in Eternal Sunshine, like down here, to be more of a reference to this movie, because we don't really see that much orange in Ateez Color Theory stuff yet. I do think it's kind of more to tie it to this movie, because orange is one of the important colors in this movie. I do think that maybe, like One to All for yellow and green, this might be our introduction to orange, and what orange means in the future might come out of this. So something to keep in mind. A lot of the sky in Eternal Sunshine, so much blue. And then Sungho here, he's blue. You got the blue sky, the red car, which is like a callback to Wave. You get the like blue versus the red house, and they kind of move between them. And the green trees. And I see the snow in Eternal Sunshine, hot and cold, day and night, summer. That's a hot summer. That's hot. Red thing. Snow, cold, blue thing. So this is like a interesting combination of like red and blue things happening, and it's also tied to this like winter and summer. Okay. The deer. There's this rainbow deer that's featured a lot in the Eternal Sunshine concept photos, especially in the special teaser clip. I don't know why this deer matters. I don't know if it's significant that he's rainbow. I haven't really seen anybody talk about it, so tell me your thoughts on the deer. This is something that will probably become important later in like a diary entry or something, so keep him in mind. Don't forget about the deer. So Turbulence. Turbulence is predominantly red and blue. There is some yellow-green in here, but not a lot, but the yellow and green that is in here is really important. So lots of red and blue. You have like blue versus red, sort of this red light, and the rest of his stuff is blue, red. The blue train, which is like a callback to Fireworks and Eternal Sunshine and everywhere else we see the train. There's some song. What song is it that has lyrics about the train? I don't remember. There's definitely a song. And then the red lights, and we get a black and white title card. Now, at this point in the story, especially if you read the diary entries, Yelseng is trapped on New World and everyone else is on Old World. So Yelseng's coloring is a little bit different in this music video. He's shown more in warm colors, right? New World colors, where everybody else is in much cooler colored sets. Now, he does show up in blue a little bit, but not nearly as much as everyone else. So, and like the paper airplane, that's like his message back to Old World to like tell everybody that he's safe, or like, okay, I guess he's, I don't know if he's safe. he does wear green, which I think is really interesting. It basically ties him to Hongjun, who's also wearing green. We'll talk about that in a sec. Jungho wears this white and green sweater. It's really hard to tell what they're, the colors of what they're wearing in this music video, because there's so much weird lighting going on and all the concept photos were black and white. So you have to look at the behind the scenes to figure out what they're wearing. Like this sweater that Songhwa wears, it looks very yellow in the music video, and then you see it under normal lighting and it's like, it's definitely not yellow. the roof, Songhwa is like sitting on the roof here that all the, like, a bunch of this music video is shot on, and the roof is green. It's, like, green stuff going on in some of Yeonho's scenes. So, Hongjun is wearing green. This jacket, it looks black. It's not black. It's green. He wears green, basically, this whole music video. And then this yellow line, which is important, that he runs along, and this is where he gets the message from Yelseng, where he gets the message from New World. This is, like, his umbilical cord to the New World. And then these yellow sneakers that we get a shot of before Wooyoung flies, they're like bright yellow in real life. The reel basically has equal amounts of black and white, red and blue, yellow and green. Just like Answer, it kind of has that balance. There's not a good chunk of color stuff happening in this music video. There are more important things that happen in this music video that I'll be going over later, so you'll understand why the reel is important to color theory. But it's also pretty new and I haven't had a lot of time to think about this music video, so my opinion on this music video might change. Here's a little summary of everything I went over, with the arrows being the color shift and whatnot. Hopefully that makes sense. Maybe it doesn't. These are all the lyrics from Fever that explicitly mention a color. Hopefully I didn't miss any. I spent a lot of time hunting these down. And this is like a summary over here of all of them. So as you can see, we still don't have any yellow or green lyrics. And so until we get yellow or green lyrics, I don't think we have fully made it to yellow green era. And it's coming. Manifest it. I want yellow green lyrics in the next comeback. I think this deja vu lyric especially is kind of interesting. Now, this is a Korean lyric and these are the translations from KQ, but if you speak Korean and you know if this translation is accurate, let me know, because scarlet in English is not true red. It's like somewhere between red and orange. And I also don't know if this is meant to be like a pun on scarlet fever. So yeah, that's sort of the overview of Fever. Okay, I just want to briefly go over spectrums and gradients and then we can get more into my actual analysis of all this. If you read my dumb little infographic about spectrums I put out a couple months ago, you can probably skip this section. I have since had a change of heart on where Twilight and Win and Thanks and Inception belong, but everything else is basically the same. So I say this in my first video, that there's not just a good or evil version of Ateez, but a whole spectrum in between. And ignoring the good and evil stuff that I was wrong about, members and their clothes fall on this spectrum. There's all this sort of stuff going on between red and blue. So like maybe where would we plot these? This can go like maybe here. This can sort of go somewhere around here. This can go like all the way down here. If we turn this into an actual spectrum, same thing. This can kind of go here. This can kind of go like here. This can go down over here. Most everything is going to fall somewhere in between, not fit 100% one side or the other. Then if we add an axis for black and white, that's what this looked like. This dividing line, kind of like old world colors versus new world colors over here. But it's not just clothes. Everything falls somewhere on a spectrum. Music videos, live performances, songs, all of it. So Treasure 2 album artwork is red with black lettering. So it maybe belongs over here in this corner. The Pirate King music video is equal parts white and black with red and a little bit of blue. So it's maybe like here. Something like The Real or Answer or Horizon, they're going to be your true neutrals in the center here. San's hair in Turbulence is black and blue. So it belongs over here. So you can kind of plot anything in here and compare it with other stuff going on. And it sort of gives you a clearer picture of what's happening with the colors. The way I show it in my video is pretty bad with just the two color categories, because it actually looks something more like this. If anyone is bored and wants to spend a lot of time making a Spotify playlist with every single Ateez song on it, ranked from red to blue, I'm just saying it would be really cool. When you try to add a third axis, it does get a bit more complicated, which is why I kind of don't have a lot of Fever songs plotted on here, because this is... I don't do 3D graphing. But you can think about it instead as like doing separate spectrums. So this is like what the Aurora music video might look like. Maybe Turbulence or Hala Hala. How do I determine if a song is red or blue? You can look at music. So musically listening to that song, what does it sound like? Is it a soft, poetic ballad versus loud, powerful, aggressive anthem? The beginning of Hala Hala versus the rest of Hala Hala? Lyrics, if they're talking about more red concepts or more blue concepts, me, I, mine, those are all red words. We, us, ours, those are all blue words. Lyrics will contain a lot of metaphorical opposites too, hot and cold, day and night. So, example, intro long journey. People want it, people dream about it. It can be different to every individual. It can complete us or it can destroy us. It can change the world. People call it treasure. So, all of these sort of opposites here that are brought up. So, people want it, that's a red thing. People dream about it, blue. And again, it can complete us, that's blue. It can destroy us, that's red. That's sort of how I would separate and flesh it, those out. You can look at live performances of songs too to decide if they're red or blue, if they use a lot of red or blue lighting, what sort of outfits do they wear on stage in the live performances of that song, what color are those, what plays on the screen in the background. Album previews too are always have interesting color theory stuff going on for each song. I have to talk about this. So Nocturne Song made it on Twitter. They made these amazing things. They wrote a program that takes a video and figures out the average color of each frame and makes it into a 1 pixel wide bar and then turns it all into this little barcode. So this is the average color of every single frame of this live performance on this date. This is the beginning of the video till the end of the video. So they're really cool, and they did it for the music videos too, because I asked. So this is what Aurora looks like, and you can see the color shift that happens in Aurora. Now, the music video ones aren't quite as clear because it takes the average color. So if you have a lot of colors going on in the frame of the music video or weird lighting, it just comes out this muddy brown or gray. There still might actually be red and blue in that shot, but it will just get drowned out by everything else. So you should absolutely go take a look at all these. They're under this hashtag on Twitter. Nothing is entirely black and white, red or blue, yellow or green. All of their content falls somewhere on a spectrum. And fever itself is a spectrum slash gradient because it is the handoff between red and blue and yellow and green. We get this smooth transition between the two. And just like a lot of gradients were used in promotional content for fever, kind of further proving that fever itself is meant to be a gradient, which hopefully means that yellow-green series will be next. All right, so this is a bunch of random tangents and things I didn't know where to put anywhere else. The Matrix. So my first draft of Ateez Color Theory was originally an essay about Wonderland, like just the Wonderland music video, and talking about the Matrix. And over time, as I added to and rewrote that script, all of the Matrix stuff got cut out. There's this famous red pill, blue pill scene in the Matrix that gets referenced a lot in pop culture, and movies and stuff. And I originally thought that the red and blue in the Wonderland music video was just a Matrix reference. I don't really know if I believe this anymore. We've never gotten an official Matrix reference in lyrics or anything, and I think Ateez Color Theory stuff is a bit elaborate to just be done for the sake of a single Matrix reference. But I do think the Matrix introduces some interesting ideas, you know, and it's this new world where humanity is controlled by AI. And sort of like, If you know how The Lion King is a very stylized, modern retelling of Hamlet, The Matrix is a very stylized, modern retelling of Alice in Wonderland. Like, at their core, those two stories are the same. Utopia is a trap. It's a beautiful prison. It's an illusion. The idyllic, pristine image of utopia doesn't really exist. You have the "let me free" lyric from Illusion, and this "let us go" lyric from Utopia. Kind of has double meaning. Let us go, as in like, please, I really want to go there. Let us go. Or let us go, as in like, I am trapped here. I can't leave. Let us go. And the fact that Utopia is a deserted island that you fly to. Like, how are you supposed to get off the island once you're trapped there? Can you even get to the island? Can you reach Utopia? I'm sorry. So when I'm talking about members' color journeys in my first color theory video, I say something like the members' representative colors from Alice in Wonderland, and then I proceed to not explain anything about that. But this makes more sense in the context of when I originally wrote that script, which was right after Wonderland came out. But there were a lot of theories written after Wonderland came out where people thought each member was supposed to correlate to a character from Alice in Wonderland. And most of this was based on their clothes and what color they're wearing. So a lot of people agreed that Hongjun was supposed to be the White Rabbit and Sanghwa, the Red Queen. And there's less agreement for all the other members. I used to, but I don't really agree with this theory anymore. I think members' colors in this music video have far more to do with their individual color journeys than matching them to a character from Alice in Wonderland. Now, here's why I think Alice in Wonderland matters. There is red-blue color theory stuff tied to Alice in Wonderland. So Alice, your main character, she wears blue, and then the Red Queen, your main antagonist, right? She's red. Just like Ateez, Alice is in a dream. This is more obvious if you read the book, Alice's Adventures in Wonderland by Lewis Carroll. But like, Alice, like, she's bored and she falls asleep. And Wonderland is this whole fantastical, like, dream that she has. So her falling down the rabbit hole, that's her falling asleep. So it's the exact same thing traveling to a new world in your dreams when you fall asleep. In Illusion, you have like the giant mushrooms, like here, and the roses, which of course match Alice in Wonderland, and the painting of the flowers, which we've already talked about. So in a lot of different music videos and concept photos and stuff, the sky is very emphasized. And like in Utopia, they have this fog machine just like going crazy in every shot of that music video. So I've always interpreted this as them being in the sky, like above the clouds. And then they sail through the sky, right? But in reality, you can't do that. You sail through water, through the ocean. And so there is this explicit connection between the ocean and the sky, where for Ateez, they are basically the same thing. They are both blue things that contrast with the red desert. And like at the end of Thanks, you have all the sea creatures, like the whale and the turtle and everything, that are swimming through the sky. Turbulence is something that you experience on airplanes, but also on boats, like turbulent waters. So the sky and the ocean are one for Ateez. And a lot of this, of course, is a reference to Peter Pan, where they fly through the sky to get to Neverland, flying to get to the New World. And just like Alice in Wonderland, in Peter Pan, they're asleep. again, this is more obvious in the book than in the movie, but these kids fall asleep, and Neverland is a dream that they have. Like, come on, you guys. Also, a footnote. The beginning of the end, that phrase, beginning of the end, that's a Peter Pan reference. It's a quote from the book. You don't even have to read very far. It's on the first page. And you can find the book for free online because it's 100 years old and there's no copyright. But it talks all about how growing up is the beginning of the end, because that's like the point that you stop believing all your dreams can come true. So when you're young, you think that all of your dreams are real. You think they can happen. There's no separation between the new world and the old world. But as you get older, you begin to believe less in your dreams and less in yourself. You begin to doubt if you can accomplish your dreams and your goals. There you go. So intro long journey, we basically get the bullet pointed list of where they have to go on this long journey. They go over the horizon, they sail through the ocean, and they cross the desert. So you put the Fever 2 triptychs together and you have the full journey. So you have the desert, you have the ocean slash the sky, which for Ateez are the same thing, and you have the horizon that separates them that you have to cross over. And it also makes the shape of the chromer if you do this with like the sand inside of it. Hey, isn't that nice? Oh my god, okay. Here we go. Every day, every night. So let's start here. Hot and cold, day and night. So day, that's a red thing. And night, that's a blue thing. And this lyric, every day, every night, is repeated in a whole bunch of Ateez lyrics. These are only some, there are more. And the first time they say this lyric is in Treasure, the song. So in a way, all of these are references back to Treasure. But given how frequently this lyric shows up, I think it's more important than just being a Treasure reference. And there are a handful of songs that will only have half of this lyric. Like, they will only say every day and not every night, or only every night and not every day. And Turbulence is an every night song. they only mention every night in those lyrics. And you have the Korean title of Turbulence, which translates to Night Flight. And almost this entire music video takes place at night. Now, we do get some sunrise stuff towards the end, especially with Jungho and Sanghwa and Yeonho's scenes. But the majority of this music video happens at night, with one exception, which is Yeoseng's scenes, where he has sunlight streaming in through the window. And Yeoseng at this point is trapped on New World. Everyone else is on Old World. My current running theory is that there is a flip in day and night depending on what dimension you're in. So if it's day in one dimension on New World, it's night in the other dimension. It's night on Old World when it's day on New World, and vice versa. Which means that as the sun sets in one dimension, it rises in the other. There's like this handoff of the sun where it sets and it travels down into the next dimension and rises up in the next dimension once you're flipped upside down. There's this handoff of the sun. The end of the day on New World is the beginning of the day on Old World. Beginning of the end. The beginning is the end, yeah. And so, in my opinion, the only time you can travel between the two dimensions is at sunrise / sunset, or another word for that is, of course, twilight. Because that is the point where the Old World meets the New World. It's the only time that they touch. The horizon is the place where red and blue come together. It's the place where the sun sets and then the sun rises. And like, you guys, like, the sunset scene in Wave 2 is when the color shift happens from blue and green to red and yellow at sunset, you guys, and this is also completely fitting that everything in New World is a dream. Like, when the sun sets, you go to bed, you go to sleep, and you wake up the next morning when the sun rises. So it's the same thing. If you're awake in one dimension, you're asleep in the other. So just like the sun travels between dimensions at night, dimensions at twilight, so does Ateez when they go to sleep and when they wake up. Now, I think all of this is incredibly relevant if we look at Pirates of the Caribbean. And in this movie, Pirates of the Caribbean, At World's End, and the beginning of the end, they're trying to get to Davy Jones' locker, and Jack solves this riddle on how to get there, which is that up is down, and sunrise sets flash of green. Flash of green, you guys, flash of green. The flash of green tells you if you're in reality. Anyways, and they're all confused because sunrises don't set, they rise. But they end up figuring it out, and they flip the boat upside down. They flip it upside down at sunset, and they arrive in Davy Jones' locker at sunrise. So many things with this. One, the idea of traveling between dimensions at sunrise / sunset. This part where they flip the boat upside down and the ocean is the sky and the sky is the ocean. We just talked about this. And then, like, three, Davy Jones' locker winds up being this barren wasteland where Jack gets imprisoned. And, like, what other place do we know of that you sail to, and it's really just a barren wasteland and a prison? Sounds a lot like New World and Utopia to me. So yet another one, Utopia, Wonderland, Neverland, Davy Jones' locker, all the same thing. I also think this is important for the Mobius strip theory for Ateez. Taya I think it's Taya. She's a YouTuber who made some Ateez Theory videos. This is her first one. I don't 100% agree with her theories, but, which, by the way, is not to bag on her at all. I am sure she's lovely and worked really hard on those videos, and you should all go watch them and leave very nice comments. But the part of her theory that I do really like, and she talks about it the most in this first video, is her Mobius strip theory. And she does a really good job of explaining it, and I'm probably going to do a shitty job of explaining it, so you should just go watch her video. But basically, if you start at one point on the Mobius strip and you go around, because of the geometry of the way it works, by the time you end up back at that point, you will be upside down. So her theory is that Holoteez and normal Ateez are at the same point on the Mobius strip. But Holoteez has already been around. We know Holoteez are the ones that have already been around because they're in the new world, right? They're the new world, they're in the future. Normal Ateez is in the old world, they're in the past. So normal Ateez and Holoteez are at two different points in time, but the same point in space, which is why they can like see each other. But they're both still Ateez. So up is down. Up is down, day is night, sunrise is set, the future is the past, awake is asleep, hot is cold, east is west, red is blue, yellow is green. The new world is the opposite, mirrored, upside down version of the old world because of this flip that happens when you go around the Mobius strip, which is the same flip that happens when you turn the hourglass upside down. And it has to be twilight for you to cross over the horizon. That was my point. That was the point of all this. I felt so ridiculous when I realized all this, because I was just walking around my apartment talking out loud to myself alone, which is where all my videos come from. And basically I ended up reenacting the entire scene from Pirates of the Caribbean where Jack is talking to himself and he figures it out. Oh my god. I have an annotated set of Ateez lyrics, and it's just covered in highlights for different songs with notes that say up is down question mark. Oh my god, I'm losing my mind. The Leaders. Okay. The Leaders is a Red song. It's on a Red album, Fever 2. And that song is written from the perspective of Holoteez. Like, they are the leaders of this new world. They're the student council. That's what the song is about. And in The Leaders, we get this description of what Holoteez wears. So on body, black suit and tie, armband on right arm. And then this Rolex line is debated a lot. I do think it's meant to be Rolex. And it could be a reference to like a watch. We don't really see a watch, but we do see the compass. I think this Rolex line is a reference to the jewelry. So Rolex, fancy, expensive watch, it's jewelry. And I consider like the hats and the masks to be a part of black suit and tie. So here's a whole smorgasbord of concept photos. You have members in black suit and tie. Boom, boom. Boom, black suit and tie. Sometimes they're missing something, like the mask or the hat. So the armband. Hyungjun is the only one we see wear the armband because, you know, it's his dream. San does wear an armband. It's in Thanks. It's on his right arm, but it's not the armband. So let me know what you think about that. But Hyungjun wears the armband in Fireworks and in The Real. But every time he's wearing the armband, he's not dressed in black suit and tie. So here he has like the school uniform, and this is obviously a black and white photo, but he's not dressed in black suit and tie here. He's wearing like that blue jumpsuit. I think each of these outfits are slight variations on black suit and tie. Like 70% of the way there, but not fully black suit and tie. There is a spectrum for black suit and tie too. And I actually think all of these outfits are probably meant to be variations on black suit and tie. And there's probably more too, like the black outfits in the Treasure music video could be black suit and tie, and they're opposite the white outfits in Pirate King. Anyways, so a lot of the like school uniforms and stuff, I do kind of wonder if the school uniforms are like the precursor, like this is what eventually becomes black suit and tie. And especially these Fever 2 outfits, Yosang and Hongjun have the hats and the jewelry and everything. And, you know, you have Sunghwa and Yeonho and Sun in a suit and tie and Jungho as well. So like it's not just Hongjun. Everybody here is dressed in like a variation on black suit and tie. Like it's like their own take on black suit and tie. And right, this is the set where they film the music video for Celebrate. And there's a lyric in Celebrate. It's something like your clothes don't define you, which is really, really interesting. So yeah, the armband and then like a whole bunch of variations we see on black suit and tie. And then the jewelry. I'm convinced the jewelry is important. It's part of the Say My Name concept photos. It's like the thing that differentiates them from the backup dancers in Hala Hala. And the pearls. Ugh, you guys, the pearls. the pearls are a thing. Everyone is wearing pearls in Illusion, and then they show up again with Holities wearing them in Answer. And they're like Jungho's like special thing, like his item, special item that he has in the Answer concept photos. And in the reel, Yosang is wearing pearls as well in both his black and white outfits. And Sunghwa is wearing pearls in the reel too. I think Wooyoung wears pearls at some point, maybe Eternal Sunshine. I might be wrong about that. These have shown up, like, the pearls have shown up way too many times in way too much of, like, a significant way to not matter. And then all the, like, lock and key necklaces, like, there's one here. Sunghwa wears one in Wonderland. There's a whole bunch. Other people have written theories about them, these, and hunted all of them down, so. Yeah, the jewelry is important. So, we see all three pieces of this getup at different times, but we never actually see any member wearing all of these things at once. Probably the closest we get is like Hala Hala and Hongjun in Fireworks, which makes sense, right? Like those are the most red music videos we have right now. So I think this is interesting and something to pay attention to. And then also a little footnote, these Say My Name concept photos, they match the Answer concept photos. You have like the border with the plastic and everything, and like these ones are red and these ones are blue, and you might want to go take a look at those again. And then this is more like a minor note on concept photos. I'm always intrigued by the way KQ sort of plays with the balance of red and blue in concept photos. So like here, this is Answer concept photos, and you have them dressed in black suit and tie, and he's Yosang is wearing red here. So this is a very red concept, but the frame and like the coloring and everything is blue. So you have this combination, this like balance of red and blue. So here, diary concept photos. There's this progression where older members match their background, and then by the time you get down to the younger members, they don't. So like Hongjun, right? He's blue, and all four of his backgrounds are blue. And then if you go all the way down here to Wooyoung, he's blue, and all four of his backgrounds are red. And the members in the middle, like, match some of their backgrounds in diary concept photos. Ugh. It's very cool. You should go look at all of them. They're really good. So here, right, this is like a very dark, aggressive, intense concept, but they're all dressed in their blue outfits. And then this is the opposite, right? It's like they're lighthearted, fresh, bright concept, the blue concept, but they're all dressed in variations on black suit and tie. So, like, they're opposites of each other, and they always, like, balance red and blue. And then, like, here, out of these two, like, Deja Vu is the intense, dark, aggressive concept. You know, like, Deja Vu is the blue, or is the red concept, but this entire poster is blue. Ugh. Anyways. So every time we've had the My Music Taste voting for title tracks, they've always put a lot of effort towards promoting the two different songs with two different color schemes. So it does make me wonder a little bit if our decisions, like our votes, have some kind of effect on the color theory stuff. Like, if we are actually the ones choosing the colors. I don't know. Let me know your thoughts about all this, and if you think we have some kind of impact. This is just future stories to keep an eye on, like concepts that I think we might get. There has been so much stuff that could definitely be set up for a Lord of the Flies concept, and it would be so badass. The, like, deserted island where they're trapped, you have the Cromer in place of the conch, you have the fire. If we get normal ATs, like, losing touch with reality and becoming holities while they're stranded on Utopia. Holity's origin story, you guys. Oh my god. And I'm calling it now. If we get a Lord of the Flies concept, I think we're gonna get a song called Savage. The word savage, it shows up in the lyrics of Treasure, the song, and Feeling Like I Do. There are a lot of songs that talk about going wild and going crazy in the wilderness, and like the wilderness. I mean, the leaders of the wilderness, that's a lyric from the leaders. So yeah, go read Lord of the Flies in the downtime before the next comeback. A Midsummer's Night Dream, there's a very brief mention of it in Yoseng's Fever 1 diary entry. And again, a lot of things that fit, like fairyland and dreams and the moon and everything. And then Fellowship of the Ring, I mean, they named their tour the Fellowship, and, you know, a long journey to a dystopian wasteland in a magical made-up world. So yeah, that's it for this section. Okay, so on to the last set of slides. If you are still watching this, congratulations, you have made it to the best part. I had an epiphany about Light just before Fever 2 came out, and I've been dying to talk about it for months, so I'm very excited. Every single thing I've talked about throughout this entire video is connected together. I gave you the dots, and the line that connects all the dots is this idea of Light. Now, this is a little bit hard to explain, so I have a little introduction part to establish some basic information about Light, and then we'll talk about some more fun stuff. So, Treasure. What is Treasure about? It's not that hard. I'm sure you know this. Treasure is a series about treasure. And Ateez defines treasure as the thing you desire, the thing that you want. People want it, people dream about it, we call it treasure. And in the first song in the first album, we get this point-blank question. What is your treasure? So if we were to summarize everything in one sentence, the treasure series is about going on a long journey to find your treasure, discovering the thing that you want. And how do you find your treasure? You find your treasure by following the light. This idea is talked about in a lot of Ateez lyrics, that treasure itself emits light. Treasure glows, treasure shines. So dazzling light, that's a song about the treasure. And treasure can even be so bright that it blinds you. It makes you go crazy. You can wind up ignoring everything else in pursuit of your treasure. So at the beginning of Treasure, they haven't found it, place nobody has found. And by the end of Treasure, or by you know, E.P. Finn, they have found their treasure. So this is Precious, this treasure that fills my hand, right? They found it. And these are the matching Hongjun verses from Treasure of Precious. And they find the light. So they ask, are you going to stop here? And they decide, no, we're going to keep going. We're going to keep discovering new things to strive for. But at the end of Treasure, they have found this light. So if Treasure is a series about treasure, then Treasure is a series about light. What is Fever about? It's not quite as easy, but Fever is a series about dreams. So, you know, like Fever Dream, that's where the title comes from. Fever dreams being vivid dreams you have while you're sick, where you can't tell if you're in reality or illusion, very fitting. And Fever lyrics talk a lot about this sickness, this illness. If you're sick and you have a fever, you sweat and you shake and you're dizzy and you just feel really bad. And all of these are the same things you experience if you are nervous or afraid. Turbulence makes you feel sick, right? It's why people throw up on airplanes and get seasick. This series talks about how metaphorically this fever, sickness, turbulence is caused by other people in society, and predominantly adults, who put expectations on you to be a certain way. It's the bumps along the way and everyone who makes you feel afraid and tells you to give up on your dreams. So the roaring winds and the turbulent waves and all of the things that will try to hold you back, but you overcome. I mean, it's a whole song in the epilogue. Better. They get better. They recover from the sickness. That's what Fever is about. So yet again, first song, first album, point blank question this time, what is your dream? And to summarize, Fever, overcoming this fever, believing in yourself and believing in your dreams. What is the dream? The dream is to be a star. Now this is very clever because you can interpret this in two ways. The dream is to be a star, as in they want to be on stage, performing, famous, you're a star. Or you could take this literally, as in stars, right? The fiery balls of light in outer space. So they ask, what form should we become? And the answer to that is a star. At the end of this road, what should we become? We should become a star. So they start out Fever in darkness, and then by the end of Fever, they become the light that drives away the darkness. So if Fever is a series about dreams, then Fever is a series about light. Let's talk about this light for a sec. Light is usually talked about in one of two ways. The first is light as something within you, something inside of you, something that is personal to you. The second is light as something outside of you, something separate from you that you follow. It guides you. Now, these lights are actually the same thing. Confusing, I know. But if we think about light as a metaphor for your dreams, passions, ambitions, desires, etc., your passion can be this light inside of you, right? This burning passion that drives you forward. Or it can be something you follow. So you follow your dreams, you chase after your goals. This is just two different ways to talk about the same thing. So you find your treasure by following your dreams, you find your treasure by following the light, you find your treasure by following your passions, ambitions, desires, etc. All of these are essentially the same sentence, right? They are interchangeable. So dreams, passions, ambitions, desires are all metaphors for light. They're all ways to talk about light. Or you have the word that Ateez uses for all of these things, which is treasure. Now, you find your treasure by following your treasure? What? That doesn't make any sense. But if you think about it instead as you find your treasure by following the light emitted by the treasure, because treasure is light, treasure glows, it makes more sense. So, did you find your dream? Did you find your treasure? Yes, we have finally found it, covering us like shining light. Now we get the two primary light sources for Ateez in music videos and stuff. The first is fire. And you might say, okay, fire, that's a red thing. Hot and cold, day and night, fire, hot, that's a red thing. And fire can be a red thing. In fact, fire is frequently a red thing for Ateez, especially if it's being contrasted with water. Fire being red and water being blue. But if you think about a flame, flames are not entirely red, like they're blue at the bottom. So fire can also be blue, and we do see fire sometimes talked about as a blue thing. So a spark and oxygen and fire and all of these things coming together to make the bluish light, right? All of these different things coming together, that's a very blue idea. This is a blue way to talk about fire. The second light source we get a lot of is starlight. And you might be inclined to say, starlight, that's a blue thing. Hot and cold, day and night, nighttime, stars, those are blue things. And starlight is frequently a blue thing for Ateez, but there is a red counterpart to starlight, which is sunlight. All suns are stars, and all stars are suns. So starlight / sunlight, it can be blue, it can be red, but starlight itself is neither red nor blue. It is light. And if this is the fire, the passion burning inside of you, starlight is the light that you follow, right? It ties into the whole pirate metaphor, right? Like using the stars for navigation. This is the light you follow, and this is the light inside of you. Two different ways to talk about the same thing, because these are essentially the same thing. Stars are just giant balls of fire. Fire, it is just tiny pieces of stars. We all have little bits of stardust inside of us, right? So they go together. They're the same thing. Two different ways to talk about the same thing. So these two light sources have a lot in common. Fire tends to show up more in treasure, and starlight is more emphasized in fever. The dream is to be a star, after all. And back to these fever two triptychs, we have the fire in one and the starlight in the other. So here's kind of the red way to talk about light versus the blue way. So the light as something inside you, right? Me, I, mine, those are all red words. Versus the light as something outside of you, something you follow, a guiding force, you follow the stars, you follow your dreams. And then you have fire being hot, burning, kind of overpowering, versus fire being this thing that all these different elements come together to produce. You have sunlight versus starlight. And you have sort of the green way, or not the green way, you have the red way to talk about treasure. So treasure that you are pursuing for personal gain, you're obsessed with it, you need it, you desire it, treasure. Versus the blue way to talk about treasure, the friends we made along the way, right? The goals and dreams you get to accomplish with the people you love. But light itself is neither red nor blue. It is light. Dreams, passions, ambitions, goals are not red things or blue things. They are light. So, what I wanted to set up. Treasure and Fever are both series about light. Light as a metaphor for treasure or dreams, passions, ambitions, goals. The two ways to talk about light, burning inside you versus the light you follow. We do get a couple other light sources. The chandelier in Answer, the flashlights in Aurora and fireworks, and we get lightning, but stars and fire, starlight and fire are the two primary light sources. It can be red, it can be blue, depending on the context, but light itself is just light. Hopefully we are good on all that. So, what is color? From a scientific standpoint, color is just different wavelengths of light. Color is just light, and it falls on a spectrum. Remember how important gradients and spectrums are for Ateez? This is why all of that matters. And remember how we were just talking about how eventually we're going to complete the color wheel and we're going to have every color added together? Well, every color added together is light. Every color added together is light. Color is light. Light is color. The prism, you guys. The prism. They have this prism in Dreamers. It's also an illusion and in Thanks. What is a prism? Prisms take light from the sun, a star, and refract it out onto the visible spectrum, which is what we call color. The prisms refract the light of the sun. They show you the treasure. This cover art for Fever 3, based on thermal imaging, or infrared thermography, if you're fancy like that. And you can take a thermal camera and take a picture, and it will measure the temperature and produce a colored image like this example, where warmer things are red and colder things are blue. So here you have it. Hot and cold, day, night. Hot is a red thing. Cold is a blue thing. But what a thermal camera does is it measures wavelengths of light. So you can measure hot and cold as wavelengths of light. Now, it's not on the visible spectrum. It's over here. It's infrared light. You guys, fireworks is a red song, a red music video. Fever 2 is a red album. You guys, this is red cover art. Oh my god, it's so damn clever. KQ, you're doing amazing, sweetie. You also have radio waves and like x-rays and stuff over here too. So maybe that's important too. I don't know. Tell me what you think. Eyes. Your eyes are the thing that perceives light. Color is the visible spectrum, after all. We have lots of lyrics about eyes. I especially like these ones from Dazzling Light. So, dazzling light, in your eyes, I see another me. And we get all kinds of shots of eyes in music videos. So this one didn't say my name, right? In your eyes, I see another me. And then they have the light separating them down the middle. And it's the same thing that happens in Answer, where they're at the table and they're looking at themselves and they have the light, the candle in between them. And this shot directly zooms out of Sanghwa's eye. So he's seeing the light in his eye. This shot of Hongjun and Aurora, he sees himself with the flashlight. So in your eyes, I see another me. He sees himself and he sees the light. This Fever 2 concept teaser, he sees the fire. Contrasts with the blue of his eye. Anyways, there's also a character in the Diary storyline called Left Eye, so maybe that matters. Okay, here's my far-fetched theory about the moon. In One to All, we get the song for Crescent, which has only one lyric, open your eyes. So Crescent, open your eyes. And we see this lyric repeated in a whole bunch of different Ateez stuff. My theory about the moon is that the moon is a metaphor. Everything is a metaphor. The moon is a metaphor. The moon is a metaphor for how open or closed your eyes are. So a new moon, That's you with your eyes closed. The light is being blocked, your eyes are closed. A full moon is you with your eyes completely open. You're seeing the light, which makes crescent the thing that happens in between. That's why this crescent poster says crescent becomes a full moon. And you have the bed from like Wave and Inception where they're asleep. And when they're asleep and their eyes are closed, it has red and yellow. And when your eyes are open, it's green and blue. Open your eyes also has a double meaning. It can be you literally opening your eyes when you wake up or when you go to sleep, closing your eyes. But it can also be you opening your eyes to the truth, understanding or having the truth revealed to you. You're having your eyes opened. The opening the door of truth, that's a lyric from Wonderland. Your eyes are the door of truth that opens and sees the light. So we get this dichotomy. Ignorance versus truth, illusion versus reality, awake and asleep, eyes closed, eyes open. New moon versus full moon, darkness and light. And crescent is what happens in between all of these things. Crescent is you just starting to open your eyes. So I think about crescent in the exact same way I think about horizon, which is that crescent is the center point of all of these things. Crescent is the place where yellow and green come together. It is between being asleep and being awake. And if you watch the Illusion music video, they're all asleep in Illusion. It's a dream. And if you stay all the way till the end of that music video, they play Crescent at the end, which perfectly transitions into Wave, where everyone wakes up. Crescent is what happens between Illusion and Wave, between Illusion and reality. You open your eyes. They literally travel from the new world to the old world in the transition of these two music videos. Ah. More lyrics about opening and closing your eyes. You should definitely take a look at these. I, of course, am obsessed with Aurora. This is really interesting, this lyric from Stay. So I can see you even if I close my eyes, right? Because they are seeing themselves. This lyric from Illusion. The symbol on the armband. The symbol on the armband it's the instructions on how to travel between the new world and the old world. So one, you need to flip the chromer upside down. That's why the chromer is in the shape of the infinity symbol. The Mobius strip up is down. You need to have the star, the light within it, setting or rising. That's the circle. When Yelsing breaks the chromer, the light inside of it goes out. There's a star within the chromer. And when Yelsing breaks it, the light goes out. The chromer is light. It glows. It's the treasure they're searching for in the diary entries. So it has to be sunrise or sunset for you to travel between the dimensions. The sun has to cross over the horizon in the center of the chromer. And then the phases of the moon on the outside. You have to open or close your eyes to be able to go to the other dimension. You have to be asleep in one dimension to be awake in the other. That is all three parts of this symbol and what you need. And then like here, you have Hongjun in the center, like replacing the circle because he's the star. Light is color and color is light. In the tour announcement, the light from the chromer, the star inside the chromer, the star turns everything from black and white to colored. Boom. In Peter Pan, second star to the right, straight on to the morning, they follow the stars to get to the new world. Utopia is a mirage. This is what all the lyrics of Utopia talk about. So, faint utopia where we can almost touch it, but can't. That's why utopia is a lie. It's a trap. What is mirage? It's this optical illusion where you think you see an oasis, some kind of water in the desert, but it's really just a reflection of the sky. And this is what a real one looks like. It's caused by the refraction of light coming through the atmosphere, which is why the sky matters so damn much in Ateez content, right? And here they have all the plants, all the stuff from Utopia. The sky matters. Every time you see the sky in an Ateez music video and any piece of Ateez content, you're seeing Utopia. Utopia is really just the sky. It's a reflection of the sky. That's why mirrors are important. It's a reflection of the sky. So here, this line, there, that's treasure in the clouds. So treasure, that's light. Clouds, that's the sky. So light plus sky gives you Utopia. And here again, you have the sky reflected onto the surface of the desert. When you see a mirage, you think it's water off in the distance. The ocean is the sky and the sky is the ocean. These two things are effectively the same thing for Ateez, and this is why. Because Utopia is a mirage. It's a trap. It's a trick. The sun goes up in smoke in fireworks, again, drawing that parallel between fire and starlight. If you watch the fireworks music video really closely, Wooyoung is actually the one who sets everything on fire. He drops the lighter, which spreads and burns the tree down. Now, we don't see his face when he does this, so we don't know if this is an accident or on purpose, but Wooyoung is the one who ends up burning the new world to the ground. And he's the one playing with fire in illusion. My god. The constellations in Deja Vu are important. Constellations are stars. Jungho, he like literally becomes a star. I'm not completely sure what this one is. I think it might be the crystal ball that we see in illusion. So tell me your thoughts on what you think that is. The glass boxes that they're always imprisoned in, it's because it's an attempt to contain their light, to keep the stars from shining. When they leave, so does their light. Things and people all along the journey will try to stop you from accomplishing your dreams, passions, ambitions, goals, but you will overcome that and continue to shine. The dream is to be a star. The hats, the masks, black suit and tie, it's worn by Holotees to try to hide their light, to keep them from being discovered by android guardians. It's a disguise. They're hiding. All this stuff, all these photos, all this stuff with Holohala is black and white because they're hiding their light. Without light, you can't have color. You need to go watch the Fever 2 concept teaser 2. This whole entire video is about light. It's very important. Twilight is a song about light. Hala Hala is a song about light. Desire, song about light. Light, obviously, is a song about light. Promise, the promise they make, is to be light, to be a star. That's the promise. Illusion, Aurora, Mist, Precious, you become one with the color that the lights gather to create. Color is light and light is color. If without you. This is one of the songs where like every single lyric is about light. It shines like a star. It brightens up the place. Dye this place, you color my heart. The light is what is responsible for the color. Color is light and light is color. Answer, star 117, dear diary, to the beat, fireworks. What are fireworks? They're lights you shoot up into the sky and they explode. Take me home. Celebrate. In celebrate, they're talking about like celebrating your birth. So you have birthday candles, which are light. Dreamers, eternal sunshine, eternal sunshine. That's what they promised to be. Not too late. Turbulence. It's every song. Every song on every album, every music video, every series is about light. So let me ask you, what is your treasure? What is Ateez's treasure? Come on, you guys. It's us. It's their fans. We are the light We are their aurora. We are every color added together. We are what they didn't have all the way back at the beginning. The light sticks, you guys. Light sticks. That's why when you buy a light stick, it comes in a box shaped like a treasure chest. Because it's the fans and the light we shine that are the real treasure. And this goes the other way, too. What is Ateez treasure? It's Ateez. They're the rising sun. They are our light who guide us through dark times. They are our stars. Get it? Because they're singers and performers. They're stars. They treasure us and we treasure them. Treasure is not a noun, it's a verb. Thank you for coming on this very long journey with me. I treasure all of you a lot.